Hi, I'm Anton. I'm a developer in Montreal, and I run a small blog called Catbus, and I like transit and urbanism and open data. So one thing that was great, earlier this year, the city of Montreal released an aerial photo survey that they'd done in the 40s of the whole island. That's a lot of images of great quality. The way they published it wasn't very great. So on their website, they published a zip file. Inside the zip file, there's a bunch of spreadsheets. And if you look at one of them, you basically get the list of links to where the photos are. And if you click on the link, it opens up this giant image, this huge scan of a huge photo in the web browser. And basically, these images are too large to look at a browser in a nice way. Browsers are not meant for images that large. So it was published, and there was a lot of people on Reddit trying to find their house, and it was really hard, because basically it's impossible to find a specific location. So I thought to myself, maybe there's a better way of dealing with this. In general, the way to do it is to fire up your favorite GIS software, then load an image and orthorectify it, align it to a proper coordinate reference system, and then align all the images together, stitch them together. The problem is, we have 3,924 images, so that's going to take a lot of time. Plus, some of the images have like no features that you could compare to any modern map, so you wouldn't really know where it is. So we did it the other way around. Rather than first referencing them and then stitching them, we thought, well, what about we just use some stitching software? So a collaborator used a professional panorama stitching software, not really the correct tool for this, but he was able to stitch together downtown areas in the plateau into this giant image. When he gave me this image, it was so large that I couldn't even look at it as a whole. It was like too large, basically. I only could look at it in little sections. I couldn't zoom out. So what I did with this image, I found a couple of points that I could match to a modern map, and I found the pixel location, and I found the latitude-longitude location on a modern Google Maps. So then I wrote a couple of Python scripts. You know, this is really this whole talk fills in the category of cool things I did with Python. So I wrote a Python script that then aligns this original image with the modern Mercator projection of the world, basically what Google Maps used. And it also tiles this large map into small tiles, exactly the same scheme that Google Maps and Bing, et cetera, use. So this way now, we can put this on a website, which is this website, and it allows you to switch back and forth between the old view and the new view. So you can zoom in and browse around. So for example, with this, you can look at it and say, well, you can see how neighborhoods were torn down to build a highway in downtown. You can see how the McGill University campus grew over time. You can see how the Île Saint-Hélène was enlarged to build an amusement park. You can see the villas in downtown turned into skyscrapers. Rail infrastructure disappeared. And the mountain, well, it basically looks the same. So this website is great, and there was a lot of positive feedback for it, but it really only covers a relatively small area of the whole island for which we have the imagery. But the strategy we're using, it doesn't scale beyond this point. This is the limits of this technique, of this hack, in a way. So already, near the edges of the map, you see the matching is really bad, like the new and the old river don't line up, and we have some stitching errors. So in order to see to maybe try to improve it, let's look at how stitching software works. So this is an open source software called Huggin. And the way it works, it basically finds reference points between old and new, between adjacent images, and says, well, this point matches to that point. So it finds these automatically using vision algorithms. And then it tries to solve a problem of aligning all these images and positioning them and projecting them in such a way as to minimize the errors between the points that should be the same point. So in a way, you can stitch them together well, but this process doesn't really force an image to any particular point. There's no global constraints. There's only constraints on adjacent images. So it's possible for the images to float away as you go towards the edge, which is exactly what's happening. So I thought, isn't there a way maybe to add some constraints globally? And the way I thought is, what if I add reference point between the old images and the map? So I use the same software. Let's have some reference points between adjacent images, but manually I can add a point between an old photo and a map that I just supplied. And this way I can force the aerial photos to be in like to be mapped into the coordinate reference systems of the map, like into the space of the map. And this is exactly what happened, and it worked pretty well. So basically, this is a tool that's in development. The website, in a way, was just a prototype of playing with these techniques. And I heard that the Archives de Montréal, they're planning to actually publish a couple of more aerial surveys. So really, what we hope to build a tool that with relatively few reference points, and this example was done with only one reference point per image, rather than several per image to align them, to be able to create a layer that's proper out of all of these surveys and then put them on a website and then let people really explore. So thank you very much for listening. And apparently, we have to shout out for PyCon 2014, which is in Montreal. Thank you very much.